closer look at circuits. Any time moving charges find a closed loop to travel in, that's a circuit. There are three basic types of circuits: series, parallel, and complex, which is a combination of series and parallel. Exercises with these three types usually involve solving for the voltage, current, or resistance in the circuit. To organize all the information involved in complicated circuits, it's helpful to use a chart called a V.I.R. chart. A V.I.R. chart is a table with blanks for the voltage, current, and resistance in our circuit. We use Ohm's law and our knowledge of how circuits work to fill in the blanks. Once all the blanks are filled in, we know everything there is to know about voltage, current, and resistance in our circuit. Before we get practice using V.I.R. charts to solve circuits, let's remember some of the rules about series and parallel circuits. In a series circuit, the total current in the circuit is the same across every resistor, and the total voltage across the circuit equals the sum of the voltages across each resistor. Also in a series circuit, the total resistance equals the sum of the individual resistors. In a parallel circuit, the voltage in each branch of the circuit is the same, while the total current equals the sum of the current in the branches. Resistors add inversely, so that 1 over the total resistance equals the sum of the inverse of the individual resistors. This V.I.R. chart is for a circuit with three resistors. We're calling them R1, R2, and R3. We want to fill in what the voltage is across them, what the current is through them, and what is the resistance of each one. In the bottom row, we'll figure out those values for the entire circuit. The first step is to fill in any blanks in the table we can. We know all three resistor values and the overall voltage. Remember that the tools we have to work with are Ohm's law and our knowledge of how circuits work. In this case, with the information we have, there's only one thing we can do: add up all the individual resistors to figure out the total circuit resistance. Since we're working with a series circuit, we find the total current resistance by adding up each individual resistor. 7 ohms plus 38 ohms plus 20 ohms equals 65 ohms. Great. So we fill in the blank for the total resistance with 65 ohms. What can we solve for next? If you said total current, you're right. We can rearrange Ohm's law so that it says current equals voltage divided by resistance. 45 volts divided by 65 ohms gives us 0.69 amps of current. We fill that blank in on the chart. We don't have enough information to use Ohm's law again, but we do know that we're working with a series circuit, and in a series circuit, current only has one path it can travel. It doesn't branch off or get depleted anywhere. That means, in this circuit, current is the same everywhere, through each resistor. The total circuit current is the same as the current running through R1, R2, and R3. So we fill in all the blanks for the current with 0.69 amps. The last thing left is to solve for the voltage across each of the three resistors. For this, Ohm's law will get us where we want to go. Anytime you know two out of the three variables within a row, you can solve for the third using Ohm's law. The voltage across R1 equals the current 0.69 amps times 7 ohms, which equals 4.8 volts. The voltage across R2 equals 0.69 amps times 38 ohms, which equals 26 volts. The voltage across R3 equals 0.69 amps times 20 ohms, which equals 14 volts. Let's fill in these last blanks in the V.I.R. chart. To check if our work is correct, we can apply our knowledge of how the numbers should add up. The voltages across the three resistors should add up to a circuit total of 45 volts. Adding the voltage across R1, R2, and R3, we get 44.8 volts. Within rounding error, it matches what we expect it to match. Current is the same everywhere, a series circuit. Looking at our I column, we see it is. And for resistors in series, the total resistance equals the sum of the individual resistance. 7 ohms plus 38 ohms plus 20 ohms equals 65 ohms. So our resistance values add up as expected. With the chart complete, We can answer any questions about voltage, current, or resistance in this series circuit. So that's how to solve a series circuit using a V.I.R chart. Now let's try the same method, but with a circuit built in parallel. Just like before, our first step is to fill in all the blanks in the V.I.R chart we can, based on the circuit information given. Here's what that would look like. Unlike with the series circuit we just looked at, here we have a couple of options. We could add up the resistor values to solve for overall circuit resistance, like before, but there's also another possibility. Remember that in a parallel circuit, the voltage used up across each branch of the circuit is the same. And with the circuit in our example, since there are only three resistors that are all wired in parallel, the voltage used up in each one is the same as the voltage provided by our battery. That means we fill in all the blanks in the V column. They're all the same, 14 volts. Great. So looking at the chart now, you may see an opportunity. Remember, when we know two out of three numbers in a row, we can solve for the third. We can use Ohm's law to discover the current running through each of the three resistors. We'll call those currents I1, I2, and I3, and solve for them using a rearranged form of Ohm's law. I1 equals the voltage across R1 divided by R1, which equals 14 volts divided by 10 ohms, which equals 1.4 amps. I2 equals the voltage across R2 divided by R2, which is 14 volts divided by 25 ohms, which equals 0.56 amps. I3 equals the voltage across R3 divided by R3, which equals 14 volts divided by 4 ohms, which is 3.5 amps. Let's fill in these current values in our table. In parallel circuits, if we know the current moving through each of the branches, we can add them together to figure out the total circuit current. This means we can go further in filling out the V.I.R chart. We can add the current in each of the three resistors to solve for the total circuit current. I total equals 1.4 amps plus 0.56 amps plus 3.5 amps, which equals 5.5 amps. The last step in filling out our table is to use Ohm's law once more to solve for overall circuit resistance. The total resistance in the circuit equals the total voltage divided by the total current, which equals 14 volts divided by 5.5 amps, which is 2.5 ohms. With that, we have a completed V.I.R chart for this parallel circuit. Now we can move on to solving a complex circuit, a combination of the series and parallel circuits. If you look at this circuit, you can see that there's a parallel piece to it as well as a series aspect. So we have our complex circuit, and now we'll solve for current, voltage, and resistance, step by step. Once again, a V.I.R chart will help us organize all our information. Take a minute to draw a V.I.R chart for this circuit. Did you draw something like this? If so, great. If not, let's draw one together. Remember, a V.I.R chart includes one column for voltage, current, and resistance, a row for each resistor, and one last row for the total V, I, and R in the circuit. Now, what's the first thing we do? Right, we fill in all the given information. In this case, we know all the resistance values and the total voltage for the circuit. As we look over this chart, what could we do next to fill in boxes? We don't know the voltage across any of the resistors, and we don't know the overall individual current running in our complex circuit. That leaves us with resistance. In general, when you have a complex circuit, you'll approach it by solving for the equivalent resistance in the circuit. This is easier said than done, because remember, our resistors are set up in a parallel and series arrangement and don't easily combine together. We'll have to add them in a step-by-step process, being careful to follow the parallel and series rules of resistor addition. Our goal is to figure out the total resistance of our four resistors in this circuit. We can begin by dividing our resistors into which ones are arranged in series and which are in parallel. R1 and R2 are in parallel, and R3 and R4 are in series. Since R1 and R2 are in parallel, that means their equivalent resistance is calculated using the parallel resistor addition rule. For two resistors in parallel, 1 over R total equals 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. Let's find a common denominator for our values on the right. That will be R1 times R2. This makes our value on the right of the equation R2 plus R1 divided by R1 times R2. To get R total in the numerator so we can solve for it, we take the reciprocal of both sides and we are left with R total equals R1 times R2 divided by R2 plus R1. Plugging in 3 ohms for R1 and 8 ohms for R2, we find the total resistance of the parallel resistors in our circuit is 2.2 ohms. Now we move on to R3 and R4, the resistors that are arranged in series. Remember the series addition rule says that the total resistance equals the sum of the individual resistors. In our case, R total equals R3 plus R4. Plugging in 5 ohms for R3 and 10 ohms for R4, our total series resistance is 15 ohms. At this point, it will be helpful to redraw our circuit to reflect the progress we've made. We've solved for the equivalent resistance of both the parallel and the series resistors. That means we can redraw our complex circuit to show these equivalent values in place of the original 4 resistors. Here's what that looks like. Since our goal is to solve for the total resistance in the circuit, we have one last step to add these equivalent resistance together. Since they are in series, R total, the overall resistance of our circuit equals 2.2 ohms plus 15 ohms, which rounds to 17 ohms. We solve for the equivalent resistance in this circuit. At its simplest, the circuit's resistance can be represented like this. Now we can return to our V.I.R chart and fill in the box for total circuit resistance. It is 17 ohms. What do you think we can do next? If you said solve for the total current in the circuit, you're right. Now that we know total voltage and resistance, we know 2 out of the 3 variables in a row, and we can use Ohm's law to figure out the total current. Ohm's law says the voltage equals current times resistance, which is the same as saying that current equals voltage divided by resistance. I total equals V total divided by R total, which is 12 volts divided by 17 ohms, which equals 0.71 amps. As we fill in the total current box in our table, we can also see that the total circuit current runs through R3 and R4. After all, they are arranged in series. We know 2 out of 3 variables for resistors 3 and 4. So let's solve for the voltage across these resistors using Ohm's law. The voltage across R3 equals I3 times R3, which equals 0.71 amps times 5 ohms, which is 3.6 volts. The voltage across R4 equals I4 times R4, which equals 0.71 amps times 10 ohms, which equals 7.1 volts. Now let's see what we should look at next to finish our chart. We still need to find the voltage and current for resistors 1 and 2. What value is the same for resistors in parallel? If you said voltage, you're right. So how can we find what the voltage is for these two resistors? Remember, we calculated the total resistance for these two in parallel to be 2.2 ohms. The total voltage across this equivalent resistor would be equal to 0.71 amps times 2.2 ohms, which gives us a voltage of 1.6 volts. Because this equivalent resistor is made of two resistors in parallel, the voltage across each one will be 1.6 volts. We can now put that in our chart. We now know 2 out of the 3 variables in our rows for resistor 1 and 2, so we can solve for the current through these resistors. I1 equals V1 divided by R1, which equals 1.6 volts divided by 3 ohms, which is 0.53 amps. I2 equals V2 divided by R2, which is 1.6 volts divided by 8 ohms, which is 0.2 amps. With that, we can complete our VIR chart for this complex circuit. We can now specify the voltage across any resistor in the circuit. We have all the resistor values, and we know how much current runs through any and all parts of the circuit. The last thing is to check that our solutions make sense. Check number 1. If we add up our individual voltages for any given current path, do we get the total? 1.6 volts plus 3.6 volts plus 7.1 volts is 12 volts? Within rounding error, it matches what we expect it to match, 12 volts. Check number 2. Does our total current running across the parallel branches equal the current running through the rest of the circuit? 0.53 amps plus 0.20 amps equals about 0.71 amps. Great! So our results hold up as we test them against what we know to be true of our series and parallel circuits. That's a closer look at circuits. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.